Another major area that you've heard me talk about a lot recently is the development of in-house casting processes for turbine blades here at PC1. As you're aware, we've been waiting for some critical bits of equipment to arrive to allow us to start doing the turbine blade casting process trials. Well, good news, the equipment's here and the cell's going together right now. Let's go and have a look. Casting is a crucial process in the manufacturing of a plethora of parts within the gas turbine engine. In many respects, it's the only way you can make some of these components. Once you've done it, you can cost-effectively make exquisitely complicated parts out of really difficult materials. But the challenge with it is to do so, you need a lot of complex and specialist equipment. What we've done here is build the very first development casting cell here within PC1 that will subsequently upscale once we've perfected each of the final stages of these processes. You'll remember from some of the previous updates that whether you're making engine casings, gearbox casings, or even precision turbine blades, then you always start with the investment itself. So this is a wax pattern or a rapid prototype pattern that will later be burnt out of the mold to leave the void of the shape that you want to fill with the specialist material. So to carry out an investment casting process, you have to have the ability to produce the patterns or the waxes or the rapid prototype parts. Then you have to be able to produce the molds themselves, which can be either be block molds or shell molds, and then once you've done that, you have to have the ability to both melt and pour the superalloy materials themselves. So let's have a look at the key ingredients of these processes in terms of the plant and equipment that we've invested in here. So in terms of producing the molds that we use to create each investment casting, there are two ways of doing it. The first is using block molding, and that's a process where we create essentially a whole block with just an impression inside, or the more commonly used process for turbine components is shell molding, in which case you take your components, you dip it in a ceramic based slurry containing fine flours and fine sands of ceramic materials mixed with binding agents. And what you do is you take your tree of turbine blade waxes, you dip them into the slurry, and then you bring them over to a humidity controlled chamber where they're allowed to essentially fully solidify. And then you'll go back to the slurry tank and build up 2, 3, 4, however many layers you need, subsequently bringing them back to the humidity chamber, allowing them to cure before you put a final thick coat to give it some strength, and then it can go into a furnace to be baked and cured and finally ready to burn out the impression, the wax impression from the inside, and then develop its full strength ready for casting. What we've got here is our mold heating furnace, and this is a production scale furnace for all of the components for the GT50 engine, both rotating components like the turbine blades, nozzle guide vane blades, interducts, bearing chambers, all these sorts of components that need to be made out of very specialist materials. They will sit in here for many hours to be heated up, firstly to cure the ceramic shell itself, but then to heat the mold to a temperature sufficiently hot that when we pour the liquid superalloy into the mold, the liquid superalloy stays hot enough for long enough to fully fill the mold before it then starts to freeze and solidify. So the molds are heated here, and then we come over to the next piece of equipment, which is our vacuum induction furnace. And what we do in here is at the top, there is a crucible into which we put the stock superalloy material. So there's a crucible sits in here. The stock superalloy goes into the crucible here. We can then melt the material and then release it through the hole that you can see at the bottom into the pouring chamber. And the pouring chamber is this huge vessel down at the bottom of the furnace. I'll just show you that here. So it's still got its shipping ties on it. So our mold sits in this vessel at the bottom of the chamber, and then when it's closed and sealed, vacuum's drawn, and we pour the materials down into the mold that lives in there. So it's a relatively simple process, but requires a lot of very careful control of all of the crucial parameters to make it work properly. Once the liquid metal is filled the mold, it's left there to solidify. Once it solidifies, we can release the vacuum, pull the mold out, knock off the ceramic shell that's left around the part to reveal the tree of turbine blades or the casing with its runners and feeders and sprues still attached. That can then come into a vapor blasting chamber here, and that allows us to clean up the rest of the surface of the blade of any ceramic debris that remains attached to the surface of the casting before it then can go off to the machine shop to have the excess material or the runner sprues, feeders, that sort of stuff cut away and returned for revert, leaving just the bits that you want, the blades, the nozzle guide vanes, the interducts, the castings, the actual parts that you want ready to be machined to their final state.